Hello students, today you are going to learn about data handling and probability. So let's start with data handling. Before starting, first of all, we must know what is data. Data is the information which can be in the form of numbers, words, pictures, digits. It provides us with the facts. Now, a collection of information in the form of numerical figures is called data. Let's see the example. Marks of 5 students: 78, 65, 90, 47, 81. This is called data. Now, moving further, let's move to data handling. Data handling comes under the branch of mathematics called statistics. Statistics is the branch of science which deals with the collection, classification, tabulation, and interpretation of numerical data. Means, statistics is the science of drawing useful facts from some data. It includes systematic collection, presentation, and interpretation of data with the view to find answers to some specific questions related to the data. Industrialists, businessmen, farmers, meteorologists, all thoroughly depend on statistical analysis. The usefulness of a statistical analysis depends on the relevance of the data collected and analyzed. Mainly, there are two types of data. First is primary data and second is secondary data. Now, let's learn about primary data. Data collected by an individual or his representative is called primary data. For example, if a person wants information about the number of school-going children or the number of a family members of the employees of a firm, then either he or his representative gets the information from every individual of the firm. In this case, collected data is said to be primary data. Next is secondary data, the data which is collected by someone else and used by the investigator for his requirement is called secondary data. The main sources of obtaining secondary data are, first, data published by the state agencies or central government agency. Secondly, reports published by some international organizations, etc. Now, let's learn about raw data. When information is collected and presented randomly, then it is called raw data. The another name of raw data is ungrouped data. The data which is collected and shown as it is without any specific arrangement is called raw data. For example, height of 5 students of class 7 are given below: 125 centimeter, 120 centimeter, 126 centimeter, 119 centimeter, 122 centimeter. This is said to be raw data because it is shown as such without any changes. Now, to get a better understanding, we arrange the above marks in the ascending order. Now we notice that a particular observation occurs many times. The number of times a particular observation occurs is called its frequency. The frequency of a given data is the number of times it occurs. When we organize the data in tabular form, it is called the frequency distribution table. This makes it easy for us to understand and interpret the given data at a glance. Now, the next topic is representation of data. The representation of data for easy understanding and meaningful comparison, the raw data will be represented in three forms. First is tabular form, second is pictorial form, and third is graphical form. And there are many other forms. Tabular form, pictorial form, graphical form. And the other forms are pictograph, line graph, bar graph, histogram, pie graph. So first we'll go through pictograph. In a pictograph, numerical data is represented by the means of pictures. Second is line graph. In a line graph, numerical data is represented by the means of lines by joining different points. Bar graph. In a bar graph, numerical data is represented by the means of bars. Bars, that is rectangles of a uniform width with equal spacing between them. Next is histogram. In a histogram, a frequency distribution is represented by joining adjacent bars. Last is pie graph. In a pie graph, numerical data is represented in a circular form, that is by a circle. It is called a pie chart or circle graph. Thank you.